Okay, the mummy is settling down for the night, and I have put the little baby, the unwanted little baby, under its mum. And as far as I know, it's still under its mum now. There's two little ones that have just come out. That's basically my fault because I brought this lump of wood to them, covered in ants, so that they'd have something to eat, to give her a bit more encouragement to take on that little one. So now, if they can get through the first 24 hours and keep warm, which is what I've done with that little baby under him, that little baby will be alright tomorrow, hopefully, because it just needed to be kept warm for 24 hours, and now he can live off his egg sac or something, whatever it's called. But after that, it's all going to go a little bit peep-tong wrong. Look at these little guys. Look at him. I put them feathers there myself just so that, you know, just be a bit encouraged to keep happy. Right, I'll come back in the morning. As you can see, I filled up this pit that was there. I put a little feather in it as well. And I filled up this pit because it's right next to the nest. I tried to barricade it a little bit because my little pal could just pop out and fall down to his death. So that's why I've padded it up. Because when I build nests in stupid places, like some people have nests in tower blocks and then poor little babies, they fling themselves out. Now, it's all right being in a tower block, but you've got to barricade your windows when you've got tiny ones because they will fling themselves out. See how they pop underneath? Look, they pop in and out. They pop in and out. That's my friend. No, it's not my friend. My friend could, for all I know, he could actually be he could be squashed flat. I do think it's a little bit weird, seeing as though I'm in Australia, that I've turned proper from Sheffield, which is where I lived for only 3 years, but I am from the Midlands, and, you know, that's the way it is, so, whatever. Anyway, hopefully my pit is filled, and look, there's mummy, and that big chunk is what I brought along with the little creatures on it. I'm really hoping that the little white one, what we've been looking at, with the little black dots on its head, is not now dead under its huge mum. She's picking them feathers now. She wants them, you see, she's picking them for herself. That was my gift. She's picking the feathers for herself now. There's baby number three. Settle down now for the night. Settle down for the night. Baby number three is under its mum now. Touch wood. Sorry, baby number four or five. Anyway. She's going to the ants. She's a living ant. Hopefully both in bed, it will be just enough to keep her on that little blondie friends that we love, whom I love anyway. My abandoned baby hopefully will be integrated into the family with these special measures that I've taken. And in the morning, I hope I don't find him dead flat. But if he falls into the pit, he won't be too bad. It won't be too bad though. It is a deep pit. I've stuffed it no end anyway. Good night, mummy. Good night. That's right, all the little babies have tucked themselves in now. But night night, babies.